The Pentagon has announced that Raytheon Technologies and Northrop Grumman have each won contracts to continue developing hypersonic weapons interceptors. Each contract so far is worth some $61 million. In November 2021, the Missile Defense Agency chose two companies, in addition to Lockheed Martin, to design the glide phase interceptor for regional hypersonic missile defense. The interceptors are intended to counter a hypersonic weapon during its glide phase of flight. That's a challenge because hypersonic missiles can travel more than 5 times the speed of sound. And unlike intercontinental ballistic missiles, hypersonics can be maneuvered. That makes it hard to predict its route and kill it. The interceptors will be designed to fit into the U.S. Navy's current ballistic missile defense destroyers. The Senate recently approved a new deputy commander of Army Futures Command. Major General Ross Kaufman is currently the head of U.S. Army Combat Vehicle Modernization. Kaufman received his third star and will take over as deputy of a command that was formed less than 5 years ago. The next commander has not yet been nominated after its first chief, General Mike Murray, retired in 2021. California-based Viasat will experiment with 5G to support U.S. Marine Corps operations and a broader command and control application after securing a research award from the Pentagon. Viasat will explore how 5G networking and related technologies can come together to support some operations over the next 4 years. Specifically, they will support expeditionary advanced base operations, which include the need for long-range precision fires, refueling, rearming, and reconnaissance. Viasat provides satellite and networking capabilities, and this is the third award as part of the Pentagon's $600 million 5G research initiative. A Viasat spokesperson said that the Phase 1 awards are worth some $10 million.